Okay, good morning everybody. Welcome to the Sharp Power Briefing at IFA Global Press Conference in the nice, or let's say near, the nice city of Rome. Yes. I'm happy to see you again. And yeah, today I have a big honor to announce something big. And it will not be a surprise for you now, it's related to 8K. And surely we believe that at next IFA show in Berlin, 8K will be one of the main trends of the show. So today, maybe you think, well, 8K, this is something for the future, which will not happen now, which is maybe happening in the next couple of years. And in some sense, you are right. But today, here and now, we announce the launch of the first 8K TV monitor for the European market. We start supplying the LV-70X500E to the European retailers and professional customers next week. End of April, it is going to happen. And that's not the beginning, because it started earlier already. Already in October 2017, we launched world's first 8K TV to China, in December to Japan, and in February to Taiwan, and now, in April, we launch in Europe and Russia. Right. Of course, you might think, why do we need 8K now? Most of the contents are even not available in 4K. Well, there are two answers to this. The first is related to picture quality, which is the most important topic or the most important criteria of a television. And picture quality today is not only about brightness, contrast, or color reproduction. Picture quality today is about experiencing reality, seeing it with depth. And of course, technically, 8K is another quadrupling of the pixels comparing 4K, resulting in 33 million of stunning pixels, which makes 100 million subpixels. But that's the technology side, and it's not only about sharpness. What does it mean for the consumer? When we launched 4K a couple of years ago, and the consumer saw the first 4K TV, they said, wow, this is like watching 3D without glasses. And this effect is so much stronger on an 8K TV. The 3D effect is so much stronger on an 8K TV, which then gives you an overwhelming reality when you watch your content and allows for new discoveries. And the second reason is it enables larger screens at home. And the consumer wants larger screens at home. These are GfK data for the European market 2017. So what you can see here, that all screen sizes up to 54 inches lost versus the year before. Only large screens won. 55 to 59 inch category grew by 23%, and today accounts for 14.2% in terms of volume, and 26.8% in terms of value of the European market. Today, 55 to 59 inch category is the biggest screen size category in the European market. And also 65 inches, it's quite significant. It accounts for, 14% of the European market in terms of value, and it's the fastest growing category. It grew by 37% in the last year versus the year before. So this is happening. Unfortunately, 70 inch plus is not that much important. Only 0.4% of the sold TV are 70 inch plus, which is about 2.5% in terms of value. So there must be some limitation why we don't sell and don't deliver more 70 inch plus televisions to the European market. And the limitation is resolution. 10 years ago, the standard TV was a 32-inch Full HD TV at home. By introducing 4K, we allowed, by keeping the same viewing distance, means the same distance between you and the television, we allowed already 4 times bigger screens because the pixel density of a 64-inch 4K TV is exactly the same as the 32-inch Full HD. So you could put a much bigger screen. And you see in the market data, it is happening. It is happening today that we are selling those 55, 65-inch screens a lot. And that was enabled by 4K. Now, for 8K, we even double again the diagonal, which means we can again put a 4 times bigger screen in the same space. So, 8K is the technological condition to start selling and enjoying more 70-inch plus screens at home. And even 120, 130-inch screens will become reality because a 128-inch screen on an 8K TV has exactly the same pixel density like a 32-inch screen on a Full HD screen. So the 8K large screen can easily replace the small 32-inch. Now you might say, there is not enough space in the living room. But come on, the 50s are over. The 70s are also over. And even the 90s, where this nice wall of furniture exists, are over. Today, living rooms look like this. Today, even a 70 or 80-inch screen cannot fill the wall. You have a sideboard and you have a lot of walls. So you can easily see here, a 128-inch TV on this wall. No problem, the space is there. So you see, the customer demand is there, they want larger screen, the space is there, and now the technology is there as well. And that's the starting point for new experiences, for pictures, for any kind of content at home. Ah, by the way, content. You know, I also had the pleasure to join the 4K lounge, and the questions also was exactly the same. So why do you need 4K if you don't have any content? So today you might ask, why you need 8K? No content. And of course we have to be honest. At the beginning, upscaling is the most important feature of this television. So to make sure that all 2K and 4K contents available today benefit from the 8K panel and can be enjoyed with much more depth and much more reality than before, we developed the upscaling technology in-house. And the second category, which is also important, is consumer-generated native content. So if you are shooting your photos with cameras that more than 4K resolution, of course you also need a display with more than 4K resolution to see all the details you shot. That's the beginning. Of course, there are also some initiatives already going on in professional native content. One example is Sharp is already delivering professional 8K cameras to studios. The 8CB60A is the professional 8K camcorder which we already supplied since more than 1 year. Also, YouTube supports the posting and playback of 8K contents since more than 2 years. And there's another example, Netflix is shooting Lost in Space in 8K already. And also in broadcasting, something is going on. And there Japan is most advanced. The national TV station NHK of Japan is already test broadcasting 1 hour per day 8K content, and they are targeting to start regular TV program, regular broadcasting very soon. But also in Europe, we have some kind of pilot project. In the next, very soon, we will shoot a European sports event in 8K and display it on our displays together with France Television. So please welcome on the stage Bernard.